Okay, Roland, what are we doing here today?
Well, I'm just going to tin this wire first. We're using the using some number 10 wire for a bonding system on the boat here.
On the yacht?
Yep. And okay. What we're going to do is we just want to put some of these nice ends on the end here. I'll show you a finished one here.
Yeah, okay. So yeah. that's to go over those big bolts.
That's right.
Yeah, that's very hard to do because usually they just wrap a base piece of wire around it and then it looks, it corrodes in no time, right?
Exactly.
Yeah,
it turns green. Because the boat is such a hot and moist environment.
Yeah.
With all the differences in electricity going around, it promotes corrosion. So
yeah.
Anything you wrap around is going to corrode very quickly.
Right, yeah.
And you're going to lose your connection. So you want something that you can make a nice solid connection on, like these islands here.
Okay.
So anyway, first
so you're going to just solder the eye on, right?
Yeah, the first
okay.
step is
let's
is
see the process.
You got to get some tin or some solder on the actual wire.
Yeah.
To do that, I found the torch is the only thing that heats it up fast enough. A wire
because
or
it's because it's such a thick wire, right?
Yeah, this is number 10. This is like almost like 6 TV cables wrapped together.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of metal there, and a heat gun or a soldering iron just won't quite get it hot enough there. What I do is I just tap a little on there and see if it's melting it, like if it's coating the wire, if it's just sitting on top.
Yeah.
If it's sitting on top, it's still too cold.
Yeah.
But it's already started to melt on there, so just let it go there. And don't be afraid of letting it go on fire a little bit. It's not a big deal. It's going to be covered in heat shrink anyway.
Okay,
So just tap some more on there. You want to? I've got a little piece of wood down here just so you're not dripping solder on your boat.
Yeah.
And,
Well, you're the yacht guy here, but this is an old wooden Chris Craft, beautiful boat.
Yeah, so we got a nice sort of, coating of the solder all around there.
Yeah.
And what we can do now is we'll just take one of our, I'll do a big one here for a half-inch bolt. These you got to go to an electronics store. If you go to Home Depot, I had to run around to find these things, but this is for those big bolts for your risers or for your through holes for your prop shafts.
Yeah.
You're going to need that size of bolt.
For a half-inch bolt, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, these are for number 8 wire, but we're using number 10. The solder makes it a little wider, so it's sits a bit up.
Yeah.
But what you can do is you can just crimp it down a bit, because once we get the solder on it, it's going to be one big solid piece of metal anyway.
Right, yeah.
So that's just sort of to hold it in place while we solder it.
Yeah.
What we do here is we just heat it up, and again, just wait until you're seeing the metal is shiny. Hold the wire back a bit because it is going to get hot on you. And we just, just sort of touch it. Wait till it melts properly.
Yeah.
And there we go. And then it'll just start flowing. Tip it back a bit so that your solder's running towards the wire.
Yeah.
If you get a big bulge of solder underneath here, it's going to get in the way of your bolt. And you can't get a proper seal on it.
Right.
It's all liquid right now, so what I'm going to do, just blow on it a bit. And just sort of hold it until it solidifies.
Right.
Or I suppose if you had a cup of water or something, you could speed up the process, but it doesn't take more than 30 seconds anyway.
Yeah.
And what you can do until it's probably a bit too hot, but we'll do it anyway here, is once it's cool, you just take some of this corrosion block and you just put it on there.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing you want to remember before you start this is to put your heat shrink on the back of your wires before you get both ends covered, otherwise you won't be able to get them on.
So you're going to put that heat shrink over that joint then, right?
Yeah, that's right. And I'll just turn off our torch here for a second.
Yeah.
And I'll just slide it up. I had two pieces on the wire here. I'll just slide it up until it covers.
Yeah.
And then...
it's already hot there, so...
Yeah, it's already hot, so... Yeah, you do have to wait a bit longer for this to work.
Yeah, why don't you do the other end then?
Yeah, the other end has already been cooled.
Yeah.
So usually what I do is I solder these and I set them down.
Yeah.
And then I just do the heat shrinking later.
Yeah.
So once it's cool, it'll just slow down like that.
Yeah.
Take a lighter. I use a torch because it's in front of me and I don't want to go looking for a lighter.
Yeah.
Just go like this.
Yeah.
A couple seconds both sides.
Yeah.
Corrosion block is already on there. Just so you've got your... got it all protected from the moisture and everything.
Yeah,
And there you go. It's a totally pro end.
Yeah.
And take a long time before it corrodes or snaps off. And
yeah.
And a good solid connection to protect your boat from all the corrosion and pitting that the ocean wants to do to it.
Yeah.
There you go.
I guess there's a whole other story about how to bond and why to bond and all that, but we're deciding on, we are bonding all of our brass brass things that go in the water.
Yep.
And that gives us a protection for them, and then it goes to the zincs, right? Rather than corrode the brass.
That's right, there's
it'll go to the big zinc bar, which is a sacrifice bar.
That's right.
So all of this is hooked up to the zinc bar, right?
Yep, that's right.
Okay, super, Roland, you're the man.